Welcome to Hexen. Hexen being the sequel to a game that I've played previously of Heretic. There is some story about with this. It's something about three dudes getting betrayed and whatnot, and they're going to seek something or whatever, to kill the Serpent Rider they were serving. The three of them get separated, and you end up playing as one. So that sounds a little bit odd, doesn't it? And if you look, there are, well, basically the starter pack of any fantasy game. Fighter, Cleric, and Mage. We're going to play on random, and play what card is dealt with me, to me. However, not Cleric. Cleric is the average one. Actually quite good. Doesn't really hurt in any category. Like, a fighter's really bad at Magic, that's to be expected. And, well, the Mage is, well, a Mage. Yeah, I'm not going to play as Cleric, mostly because of the fact that in doing a little bit of searching for the game, just to see what other people had done, just to see what had gone, 99% of them are Cleric. So, it might not be a great decision, since Cleric seems like the good choice for someone who's never played the game before, which I haven't, not at more than like an hour. Any time, and there was a misrecord, so there's like, you know, 12 minutes. So yeah, fighter or mage? Basically, I'm going for a coin toss. Hopefully, it doesn't give me cleric 12 times like it did the last time. Thou art a smite meister. And it gives me the mage. Didn't actually screw around with giving me the cleric 42 times. Mage is just fine for me. Actually, I know this is a little bit. Let's see where that. Unprofessionalism. Let's just. Okay. They have different settings for some reason. The cleric and the fighter are mostly melee. Yeah, I'll play the mage. The game gave me the mage. We're gonna go with the mage. Let's not get murdered first off. So that's fine by me. One of the strange things that I have found out reading about the game a little bit, just to, you know, realize what I'm getting into and whatnot. Hi guys. Is the fact that there's only like 4 weapons for everyone. So get used to the pea shooter for a while, I guess. At least I'm not punching my enemies. I'm grateful for that. So yeah, I have not played much of this. I have played a little bit. I know this starting level. There's a few things different in this game as opposed to the last game. Come on, guys. Yeah, you'll see. And you know, more medieval doomness. I suppose I could go look up names of the enemies, but, let's do what I did in Heretic and just name them on my own. I think that's a better option. Also, first time I died in the game was to those. Yeah, that was rather embarrassing, to say the least. Yeah, the very opening level murdered me. Yeah. That aside, let's take a look around. Things are destroyable, mostly, you know, well, stained glass. It's kind of obvious why that's destroyable. Hitting them with, what, a magic missile, I guess? Isn't really surprising. I don't know... I know there's differences in, I think, the items. Like, a lot of the stuff that you pick up is very similar to what it was. The controls are the same, you can switch items the same way. But I think there's a lot of difference between this and the last one, which we're gonna have to find out the hard way. Anyway, let's actually move on and deal with... Oh, I need to give you guys a name. I don't have a name right now. That's unfortunate. And I don't know about you, but if you've played any amount of Doom, or Doom games, like this one. This is, you know, Heretic, which expanded upon Doom, which this expands upon that. That's a crusher. You can't tell me otherwise. I mean, really. It might not be crushing yet, But we gotta remember what we're playing here. I mean, honestly. Come on now. Either way, I'm kind of glad he gave me the mage, but as far as I understand, the mage is the harder to play in the beginning and gets easier towards the end, which I'm fine with. The beginning is probably going to be stupid easy anyway. Oh yeah, I need to hit that. The fighter starts off really easy in the beginning, gets really hard towards the end, and the cleric is average. And yeah, this is a crusher. Surprising absolutely nobody. That's the exit, believe it or not. And that still kind of bothers me a little bit. Anyway, green key. Also, you notice that I don't have ammo for this. I don't know what that, to the right of my quartz flask, that bit, I have no idea what that means. I have no idea what, how the armor works in this game. I know the, to the left of the quartz flask is my mana, which we'll get into that once I actually pick up another weapon. We're not there yet, of course. I doubt the very first level's going to give me anything. I haven't found anything, at least. And, well, we'll see what happens from here. Thankfully, what we start with is plenty good enough to actually deal with the foes that I have currently. Also, I think there's fall damage in this game, if I remember properly. I seem to remember that in this next room, in my misrecord, falling down and actually discovering there's fall damage. Which, that's new. You know, expanding upon Heretic, which expanded upon Doom, etc., so forth and whatnot. Haven't gotten hit yet. Hopefully that's not gonna last long. Let's face it. I mean, really, it's me playing. Let's face it. Things are going to get hit. I'm going to die lots, and that's fine. Don't mind dying. Some people do. Some people get really mad about dying, and it's just like, eh, whatever. Most of the time, I just laugh it off, because usually it's something really silly. Usually. Not always. Oh, another one? Really, game? Thank you. Level's not too long, there's not much around here, there's nothing in that pot, unfortunately, or that rock. I don't know what that chain noise is. Hello, you! I need to give you guys names. You know, I was going to continue the tradition of naming things in this game, but I didn't have any names prepared. Again, professionalism, yada yada yada. Anyway, that's fine. Don't jump off that. Unless you want to take damage. Yeah, fall damage. Yeah, that's a thing. That's I don't know about you, but that's very strange. You know, okay, it's not strange to have fall damage. Oh, hi guys. It makes sense, yada yada. If you jump from X amount of whatever high up, you're gonna hurt something. You know, it makes sense, but, you know, given the time period I'm talking. So there actually is, I guess, three axes in this game. Hey buddy, how are you? I'm gonna shoot you. And that's pretty much it. We've got some gargoyle guys, which I think the name actually changes to Afrit. I think those are Ettins. I think. I know I just pretty much finished saying I don't know what their names are, but yeah, I recall now. It's fine. Anyway.
Greetings, mortal. Are you ready to die?
Bunches. If I don't die, I'm gonna actually be a little bit concerned. Let's face it. Nobody wants to watch me play a game and not die bunches. You want to see me die. Admit it. If I play a game like this and I don't die a whole lot, it's kind of disappointing, isn't it? But again, I'm okay with it. I mean, if I'm not dying at all, I'm kind of about it. Like, okay, in a blind playthrough at least. You know what I mean? Like, if I've played the game before and I don't die at all, that's one thing. Because I know what's coming, I know generally where the enemies are, yada yada yada. But in a game that I've not played before? Yeah, that's a thing. I would really like that quartz flask. And also, you notice my quartz flask didn't disappear like they do in Heretic. When you leave level in Heretic, all but one of your items of any given kind, sans a few of them, you lose all but one. Some of the other ones, you lose all of them no matter what. Let's, hey, I got hit. None of that. I believe there's still a monster infighting. Haven't had a chance to actually try that, though. Probably should at some point. I don't like darkness. Darkness is usually bad. And if you can't see this, I'm sorry, but neither can I. It's fine. Blue mana, again, at this point, completely and utterly useless. And I took some fall damage, but that's fine. As long as I don't actually die from fall damage, I see it happening at some point, me going, damn it, RPG, fall damage, really, of all things, I see it happening, but not today. 17 out of 87 monsters, 7 portals, I have 2 keys, apparently. Also, I'm moving without intending to. I probably should not waste these quartz flasks in the slightest. Is there anything on the backside of this? No. I should really look for secrets, too. And now we are in the Guardian of Ice. The thing that's different about this game is it's not... Here's the start of the map, figure it out, get to where you need to go to get to the exit to go to the next level. This game's not like that. It's a hub system. Which, the 7 portals is apparently the first one of such. I don't know how long this game is, I have no idea. I don't know how you really classify length. Like, I can't really say, hey, it's, you know, 32 levels, yada yada yada, and another Doom-type game. I really can't answer how long this is going to be. Like, most of my Doom games, Heretic and whatnot, they're all about the same length. Doom, Doom 2, Plutonia, TNT Evolution, they're all about, give or take, the same length. Yeah, no, we'll pass on that, thank you very much. Yeah. So we're back to 7 portals, we have an amulet, apparently. So, basically I need to jump between the levels and find the things that I actually need to progress onto... progress onto the next hub world thing, I guess. I hopefully I've got that right. Hopefully I've got the idea of what's going to happen in the game correct. That'd be nice. But I don't really hold out a whole lot of hope that I don't. I probably don't, let's be fair. I'm not really super optimistic. Let's face it, if you watch this channel for any length of time, I am not an optimistic fellow. I'm not. Hi guys, how are you today? Would you like to come out here and get shot by Mr. Mage Man? His name starts with a D? And if I was going to butcher his name, I'd call him Dandelion? His name isn't actually Dandelion. It's not. It's just, you know, if I was going to butcher it, that's what it would become. Hey, another portal! Are you wondering why this is called 7 portals? There's 7 of these. I think it's pretty obvious at this point. Anyway! Guardian of Steel. 108 enemies, no secrets. Again. The thing that's the problem is... usually when I record games... I... record, like, a bunch of one game... and then I need to kill you. I record a bunch of one game one week, and the next week I record a bunch of the other, and I go back and forth, and yada yada yada. That's gonna be really awkward if I have to remember something from one session, so that I can play in the next session, and actually have some sort of semblance of idea of where I'm going. So... hopefully not too much of that. And you have a shield. It doesn't seem to help you since you're not smart enough to keep it up at all times, but that's fine. Although I'm getting horrible flashbacks to what are they called? The shield and hat guys in Mega Man Legends that just stand, oh god. Those enemies, hopefully, one of the problems that was present in the previous version of this game, the Heretic, is that the weapons are a whole lot more satisfying to use. There's only a few, so maybe? I know I remember the Elven Wand not being too great, but that was one of, you know, a bunch. I have half that number this time around. Then again, they had to design this game with, you know, three different characters in mind. So, I don't know how this is gonna go, actually. Hey, buddy. How are you today? So, you know, whatever happens is whatever happens. And maybe, this time around, I'll actually use the items. Let's not actually hope for that, because I probably won't. Like, really use the items, not like, you know, just... I need to be invulnerable for this, because I can't bother to be... to deal with whatever problem I have properly. Mostly Molotars and whatnot. Anyway. I have no idea where we're going. Hi, buddy. How are you today? I'm going to call you... Snookums. Why Snookums? I don't know. I'm not really gonna call them Snookums for the rest of the game. That's just what I got at the moment. Because, let's face it, I can do better than Snookums. I was actually going to play a different game than this, but the other one I had some misgivings about, simply because it doesn't allow you to save anywhere. You know how this, I just, you know, go back here and save. Can't do that in the game that I was going to, but let's not worry about that. That is... Guys, why are you in there? That doesn't seem like a good place for you to be. Please don't shoot me. I don't really have much confidence in dodging you here. One third of the puzzle has been solved on the seven portals. Okay. One third. Is it... I just need to find three switches to go to the end, or is there more to that? Again, I have no idea. We'll find out together. Hopefully not too embarrassing myself too much. Like that. That was pretty terrible. So goes, you know, me not getting hit and... Oh yeah, by the way, those respawn. Keep in mind, I'm not in the mode that causes respawning monsters. Apparently, those respawn constantly, which, you know, I have essentially infinite ammo for this weapon, so it's really not a huge concern. Not really. You, sir, are a pain in my butt. Nice design, though. I'll give you that. You do have a nice monster design. They didn't, skimp on you being neat-looking. Do I just leave? Because I'm assuming I need the steel key, apparently. I'm not leaving that way. That I'm going to be going to the previous levels quite a lot. I assume so. Again, keep in mind that those respawn. No matter your difficulty. Again, that might be mildly important. If I really wanted to be, you know, just a pain in the butt, I'd do, you know, go back and forth and make them not ever move. But that's fine. I'm actually really looking forward to getting another weapon, because this is fine, but, you know, all I'm doing here is holding the button down and standing still and waiting for the monster to die. I'm assuming things are going to get a little bit more complicated than that, and I have full blue mana, apparently. Dooby dooby doo. Killing two-headed things. It's not really a good song, RPG. Then again, it really wasn't meant to be. Although, I would assume that between the hub areas, that I'm not going to be able to keep things. That seems likely. And yeah, I've definitely been here before. This is the previous way. But it did say one-third of the puzzle was solved. So, I don't know what that does. Do I just go back? Because I need the steel key to progress. Hey, buddy. So we're basically going to be killing those forever. Not really excited about that. But hey, what can you do, right? One of those things that I'm just going to have to live with. At least they didn't choose a horrible, horrible monster to respawn constantly. And I'm assuming at some point I'm going to reach full on items too. I assume at some point. You know, 14 quartz flasks is a little bit much. But anyway, next time, going into this portal. And hopefully the game... Hopefully I can figure this all out and not, you know, have parts where I'm just wandering around for 20 minutes not knowing what to do. Anyway, until then.